excuse the mess. My hair has been up in a bun all day as usual. And normally when I wash my hair, oh my gosh, this is like wild. Normally when I wash my hair, I'll try to dry it like so it looks good down and like curly. But I knew I was going to be straightening my hair today, so I really did not pay much attention when I was blow drying it yesterday. Alright, we're gonna start with detangling. kind of talk to. I'm not very social. I would say I'm like kind of reserved. I don't know if reserved the right word. I'm very shy and like an introvert. At least like with people I'm not really close to. And it takes me a while to like become friends with someone cool. Because part of my hair was a little wet today from when I showered. It just takes me a while to like feel comfortable with people and open up. But the girl that went, she was like really friendly, and it was just kind of nice like being able to open up a bit. And like she asked me for advice too about my career and stuff, and that just felt nice. The like work trip itself was kind of weird. Before like we went there for an inspection, like essentially checking out this equipment. Just like odd. Also, that same day when I got my hair cut a bit, just kind of like a typical trim, but I told her I wanted like curtain bangs, I guess, but I don't know why I always do this to myself, like, so I wanted a change in my hair, but I didn't want to do anything really drastic, so I, in the past, maybe like two or three times I've cut my hair super short, and like, it'll look kind of cute when it's straight. And I really enjoyed that it's like her major this week and then all of next week. So I feel bad. She's like starting in a process of there. And like, you know, I tried setting up connects, like a set of meetings for her to meet other people and like kind of get an intro to the project she'll be working on. But still. So I think I told you in another video that we are going to Europe. It's going to be my husband and I, my sister, and my cousin, who's like my best friend. Then my husband's brother and his cousin are also going. So I am so freaking excited. It's like, I'm excited but also anxious. I get like really nervous before flight. I like don't sleep well at all the day before traveling. I just get really paranoid.
Takes me a long time.
years, but the first time, like, we left him there, and he ended up getting, like, a kennel cough. Poor little guy. So we didn't take him back there again. And then, I'm trying to think, we dropped him off one other place recently. I can't remember where we went to. But we dropped him off. And that place was really cool. Like, the lady sent me, it was like for a weekend trip, where we had to go out of town. And the lady who runs the place where he stayed at actually sent me a picture, like, the day after we dropped him off. And I've talked about this in another video, because I remember I included, like, a clip of the picture that she sent me, where he's, like, smiling, like, having a good time. And she just sent me a message that's like, he's just doing great. And then the next day, when we were gonna pick him up, she sent us, like, another picture of him playing. And she said, like, don't forget to make him, like, pick up his schedules for, you know, 3 p.m. today or whatever. And we really liked that place. We wanted to drop him off there again today for this trip, but that place is, like, an hour from our house. And so, when we dropped him off the first time, it was really convenient, because it was, like, on the way to this bigger town we were going to for the weekend. But, like, this time it's not convenient, because we arrive back, like, in the States, like, late on a Sunday, and we have to drive back home. And so we won't be home until, like, we'll say 10 o'clock at night, right? And the place is obviously closed for pickup. Left, and you know, my husband asked me, like, which one do you want? psycho's like, okay, pick him up. And I'm like, no, I'm too scared. Like, what? How are you scared to pick up a puppy? But that was me. Alright, sorry about that. My sister called. But yeah, like, I was just absolutely terrified of dogs. And it's so wild to see, like, going from that, like, someone who couldn't even hold a puppy in her lap, to now me, like, cuddling A's. I'll, like, grab his face. I don't know what, like, it's not nozzle. I don't know why nozzle get like a the face of a dog in Spanish. It's like the trompa. But I'll like grab his like little face and just like tell him like, oh my baby, like, you know, he's like pretty much my child. I have no kids, but like Ace is my son. Yeah, so it's just so crazy to me to like think about that and see the difference. I, you know, love having a dog. I'm sure that dogs like still scare me on some level, but definitely not to the extent that they did before. Like, I think I guess I'm like a dog lover now, I don't know. but yeah, it's like, it's just so cool to see how much like happiness a dog brings into a home, and like they really do become part of your family. So all that said, I'm really gonna miss my baby. I already told my sister-in-law, like, if something happens to us, you have to pick up Ace from that place, and, like, you have to take care of him. Like, that's literally our child. So if anything happens to us, like, you have to take care of him, or else, like, my ghost will come on you. Okay. I feel like this video is just, like, all over the place, but, like, I personally love, live update videos. I think I mentioned that in like another video, that it just really like makes me feel connected to, like, as the YouTuber, I don't know. And I like, I don't know, it's just nice. Like, I really enjoy those kinds of videos, so hopefully, even though this one is all a mess, you enjoy it. I have been say that I like it came up as, you know, suggested at least I have some more. And you know, so a couple people that I know in real life followed me on there, and that was like kind of sweet. Like, thanks guys for supporting me. Stuff. as well.